मक्खन का घोटाला,
तेल का घोटाला,
घुमाला मैं तो डॉलर में ही नाला, खावेनी मेवा पूरी। अरे आपका अपना अमूल्य उम्मीदवार,
यू ओनली कम एवरी 5 years और विल यू कम इन बिटवीन?
यू मेक मी विन, सो व्हाई शुड आई कम विजिट यू?
The challenges of the 21st century are how to build in the majority of the world real democracies. Having elections is part of it.
The essence of democracy is that you know, the public purse is supposed to serve public goods.
At the Johannesburg Summit for Sustainable Development, all the talk was about involving people in making decisions. Some call it participatory democracy. Some call it social accountability. But what does this jargon mean? This week, Earth Report goes on a journey across 4 continents to find out.
India is the largest functioning democracy in the world, and it has significant strengths. It also has weaknesses. Now, amongst the strengths is we have been able to sustain our democracy. We can concede that it's, you know, no small matter to have regular elections, and we usually have something like around 60% turnout, which is around 600 million people, twice the size of America. But at the same time, there are some very important weaknesses, you know, of our democracy, which we really need to think about. This road should have been paved, but cement was not used. They were supposed to use these kind of small stones along with cement. But something like 1/8 of the total material that was used was cement, and the rest of it was all sand. So now the people are asking this question, so that what happened to the cement? After a struggle of 2 years, they have been able to get the documents.
Now, all across Rajasthan, there are people in many, many villages who have started demanding, wherever they have a problem with the development work that's taking place, demanding that they see the records and verify whether the expenditure that is shown on paper has actually taken place.
And the wall you see here is something we are required by law to now do, paint all the accounts on the walls of our panchayat. A wall like that, when it came up in our panchayat, all of us from the village went to look at it and found that there were large numbers of works worth hundreds of thousands of rupees that did not exist. So we came to the MKSS and asked for help. It took 2 years of struggle before we did eventually get the records. But when the records came out, it was clear that we were telling the truth. And in fact, the authorities had been lying. This is the office of the MKSS, which is an organization of small peasants and workers in the area of central Rajasthan.
Hello?
It was formed by the people of this area with the objective and the understanding that unless they collectively got together, they could not fight the insurmountable odds ranged against them.
Well, in 1996, the MKSS sat on a 40-day sit-in in Biawar at Changit, and we were demanding the right to access records of the Panchayat, which is the smallest elected body in India. We involved the entire city in and made it a people's campaign, and we involved people from all over India, and a national campaign for people's right to information was born.
It's a week to go before the state elections in Rajasthan.
We want to look at process of transparency in the electoral process, and we've invited candidates to come and tell the people face to face about what they will do for us when they get there, be answerable and accountable for the affidavits they have filed about the assets and about their criminality.
Aur baad mein akhbar ki radi main janta ke beech mein ye rona chahti hu
aur unhone ye kaha tumhare paas mein paisa nahi hai hum aapko ticket nahi denge.
In 5 baaton ko Congress ne vaada kiya.
Abhi bhi 75-80 ke bache ek tal patri ke niche baithkar school chala rahe hain. Aisa vikas hua Rajasthan ki dharti par 55 साल के अंदर.
In the state capital Jaipur, a group of volunteers and activists are collecting and processing information on the 1500 candidates.
We've been here for the last 2 weeks in which we've been trying to obtain all the affidavits which have been filed by candidates for standing for elections in the upcoming assembly elections in Rajasthan.
The Supreme Court of India passed a judgment saying that all candidates who are going to be standing for elections have to disclose details of their assets, details of criminal cases that have been filed against them in the past, and total value of land that they own, things like that.
When someone tells you that they have 513 rupees, 0.75 paisa in their bank account, you know there's something wrong there. Even half of the people tell you that they have no bank accounts at all, and you know there's some fishy stuff going on.
Ultimately, the responsibility in the democracy is ours. And if today we have corrupt politicians, it is because we have allowed corruption to happen, to take root.
One of the important democratic lessons of this entire struggle is that it's an ordinary person's voice that has now been made into a law. Because it began with a people's struggle with the MKSS, but it has led to legislation, it has led to entitlements, and it has led to the entire process being spread all over the country and to some extent outside. So it shows you how democracy can function.